Speaking of Apple, though, iOS 15. There's been a lot of rumors about the release date, new features, device compatibility, and some other updates that they're going to be announcing with iOS 15. So as of right now, we're still waiting for iOS 14.5 to come out. And it should be coming out very soon, but with iOS 15, the release date is likely to be in September of 2021. Last year, the release of the iPhone was pushed back a bit, but still, the iPhone was pushed back from September to October due to the pandemic. But even with that, we still saw iOS 14 be released in September. So it's a pretty good bet, pretty good indicator that we'll see iOS 15 be released in September of 2021. Follow that same sort of schedule. And some things that we can expect to see. iOS 15 will likely only work with iPhone 7 and later because they're thinking it's going to need to have at least an A10 chip. iPhone 6 models and anything older than that run on an A9 chip, so those probably wouldn't work. So it's going to have to be iPhone 7s and later that probably will be compatible according to rumors. Some changes. Since iOS 14 was a pretty big change, they added all of these new widgets, added a lot of the redesign of how the app, a lot of redesigns with widgets and how you can arrange apps on your phone. It's expected that there's not going to be a big major change with iOS 15, but there's going to be some new tools to make widgets more interactive, more customized, maybe make more apps into widgets. There'll be more features like that. So that is expected. Nothing major, just maybe some changes to widgets. And we'll have to wait and see what happens there. But big things that are to be expected are really just with the widgets and potentially allow you to change some of your default apps on your phone, like iOS 14.5 will let you change your default music platform from Apple from Apple Music to something else. It's expected to maybe let you do some other things like that as well.